Hi folks, I'm somewhere in the foothills of some mountain in Borneo, along the Malaysian-Indonesian border, trying to reach the mountain behind me and get bogged down in the foothills because I've been fighting for miles through this jungle and without the parang. And suddenly I see some big fruit lying on the ground. Big fruit are always interesting, even when they are not edible. This one, on the other hand, looks slightly familiar. Reminds me of a Willughbeia. There is only one problem. The Willughbeias I know, they have a pretty soft outer skin or shell or layer, and it rots away pretty easily. It doesn't usually dry like this. Then I find another one and open it. This one hasn't been eaten out from the inside. And the stuff in here also looks like a Willughbeia. But not like this Willughbeia that I've been seeing on markets all around Kalimantan and now even in Sarawak. This is this Willughbeia. I found one single fruit at a single roadside stand and it was half rotten. Well, this here is completely rotten, but it's definitely the same species. So I look up the next tree. Yeah, there is a huge vine growing up there. And there are some green tennis balls hanging on the tree. So I cut a big bamboo stick. Managed to get down one of those tennis balls. That's what it looks like. So when you see a close-up, yeah, the leaves are definitely Willughbeia leaves. The fruit is definitely a Willughbeia fruit. The stuff that hangs on the fruit is definitely not Willughbeia. When you cut it in half, yeah, that's definitely a Willughbeia, and that's pretty definitely the Willughbeia I bought yesterday on the market. However, the one on the market was half rotten, while this one here is completely green. Still, I gotta try it. Ah, come on. One single aerial, please. Here we are. One of those huge seeds. Definitely unripe. Bitter and slightly sour. It's not supposed to be eaten in that stage. Fruit usually becomes sweet only after the seeds ripen. So first the seeds ripen and then the flesh. To avoid animals to eat the fruit with the unripe seeds. So, I guess all the work was for nothing and I have to go and find myself a ripe vine. So folks, stay tuned for more fruit videos from the jungles of Borneo. By the way, this is a big part of fruit hunting. Hours of work, in this case half an hour of work to get this fruit down, and then nothing. Well, still, don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe.